Hello everyone, this is Revanth from Digital Integrative. Welcome to Tech News episode 267. The way individuals use their credit and debit cards will change from January 1st, 2022. To make online payments and more secure, the Reserve Bank of India has asked all merchants and payment gateways to delete sensitive customer data available at their end. RBI's new rule, which will come into effect from January 1st, mandates all merchants to use encrypted tokens to carry out transactions. Customers will have to either enter full credit or debit card details each time to carry out an online transaction, or they have an option to opt for tokenization. India expects at least a dozen of semiconductor manufacturers to start setting up local factories in the next 2 to 3 years after the South Asian nation offered incentives for this sector. Prime Minister Narendra Modi's government is working on developing a full ecosystem for the chip manufacturing industry and will start taking application under its incentive scheme from January 1st. The response has been very good, and all the big players are in talks with Indian partners, and many want to come directly to set up their units here. James Owles, a 36-year-old man from UK, has hired data expert associated with NASA to help him find and hold hard drive that contains around 7,500 Bitcoin tokens worth around 340 million GBP. That is roughly around ₹3,404 crore. In 2013, a former partner of Owles had accidentally tossed the hard drive into the trash. Owles is trying to recover his Bitcoin tokens, which could turn around his fortune that could make him an overnight billionaire. The Disney Plus Hotstar is now testing a new monthly plan at ₹49 for selected Android users. The OTT giant is also testing a new ₹199 plan, which includes 6 months validity with up to 720p streaming. The introductory ₹49 plan includes live cricket streaming on a single mobile device. Realme has officially revealed the Realme GT 2 Pro design. This is seemingly the master edition with a textured black finish, which is called as Paper Tech Master Design. Realme GT 2 Pro is confirmed to come with a Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 chipset. We can expect this smartphone to be releasing on January 4th. The compact flagship category has been completely ignored by companies and consumers for the past 3 years, especially on the Android camp. However, tides are changing ever since Apple restarted the compact smartphone trend with its iPhone 12 mini last year and continued it with the iPhone 13 mini in 2021. While Xiaomi is looking to compete with the compact flagship category as well, as new promo images confirm the Xiaomi 12 to be the company's first compact flagship in years. Xiaomi 11i Hypercharge India launch is set for January 6. This handset will be the first phone in the country to support 120-watt fast charging. Xiaomi 11i is said to be a rebranded version of Redmi Note 11 Pro Plus. With the Xiaomi 11i series, the company will also be announcing the 120-watt Hypercharge solution. According to the leaks, the IQ 9 series is indeed coming to India. This launch will happen by end of January, and there is an exclusive teaser video which gives some information about this smartphone. Deezo will soon launch its Deezo Watch R. This watch will launch first in India, while the global launch will follow after. Live images of its retail box have been leaked today. Electric vehicles are taking over the world one step at a time. This time around, it has taken the shape of a small inflatable vehicle that can even fit in your average backpack. The new innovation comes from Japan. The new Poimo, the portable and inflatable mobility scooter, has been built by researchers from Tokyo University. The small scooter has been built with last mile connectivity in mind, something like the distance between your bus stop and the office, or even short distances. The tiny battery and inflated scooter can manage to provide 90 minutes of riding time in a single charge, which is sustainable enough to cover short distances. The inflated electric vehicle can run up to 15 km per hour. ROG Phone 5 Ultimate will go on sale on Sunday exclusive on Flipkart. This phone has been priced at ₹79,999. It comes with a Snapdragon 888 processor and a 6000mAh battery. iPhone 14 2 reportedly feature a 48-megapixel primary camera, which is an up from 12-megapixel on current iPhones. iPhone 15 could feature the first iPhone to have a periscopic zoom lens. These upgrades are expected to bring significant camera performance improvements. World's first ever text message of SMS was Merry Christmas, which was sent on Vodafone network and received by Vodafone employee Richard Javis on 3rd December 1992. Today, Vodafone has auctioned the text message as NFT, and proceeds from the auction will be go to UNHCR, the United Nations Refugee Agency, to support forcibly displaced people. Silly Royale has added more Squid Game inspired modes in Silly Royale. Players can try out the Honeycomb, Dalgona, Tug of War and many other games. Silly Royale will also get Marble Game and Glass Bridge in the future update. Philips 2000 series 3-in-1 air purifier launched in India. It rivals a Dyson Pure Hot Place Cool portable room air purifier. The new air purifier from Philips comes with a 350 degree oscillation for more purification of air across a full-sized room. The Philips 2000 series air purifier is priced at ₹32,995 with an addition 10% discount available at launch. Erin Sherry, a resident of Philadelphia, USA, was stuck in traffic when her water broke. She then chose to deliver the baby while the car was on autopilot mode. She, along with her husband, were taking their other son, Rafa, to preschool. BYD Power is based in Las Vegas, is a leading world manufacturer of solar energy facilities, including solar generators, photovoltaic panels and related accessories, and now they made the world's first sodium-ion solar generator. With the rising awareness of global warming and climatic change, technology is trying to head towards the carbon neutrality, which urges a transition from conventional energy system to renewable ones like chemical batteries and battery-powered machines. BYD has released two models, BYD NA300 and B480. The sodium-ion batteries are considered an optimal alternative to lithium-ion batteries after doing some research and development. BYD NA300 and B480 retains almost all the features available in its predecessor, EP500 Pro. BYD NA300 and B480 sodium-ion battery power station will debut at CES 2022 on January 5th. Apart from the sodium battery, you can also expect a range of new products from BYD demonstrating their state-of-the-art technology and alternative power solution towards a sustainable future. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.